The left-hand object represents the source data, or what I have. The right-hand object represents the output data, or what I want to get. We call these objects feature types. The name of the feature type represents the name of the input or output table. By dropping down the arrows, I can also see what attributes are being read and written. As an FME-er, you will often hear the word schema. This is the simple title we have given to table names and attributes. To get exactly what I want in the output set, I must edit the output schema. Click on the cogwheel icon to open the feature type properties. If I want to rename the output table, I can do so under the General tab by changing the text in the feature type name field. To edit attributes, I click on the User Attributes tab. Here I can see a list of attributes currently being created on the output dataset. If I want to remove an attribute, I can do that by clicking it and pressing the minus button or delete key. I can rename an attribute by clicking a name and editing it. I can change an attribute type by selecting it from the list. Notice that only data types permitted for the current format are being shown. I can add a new attribute by entering a name and selecting a data type. When I click OK, the changes are reflected on the workbench canvas. Notice how one connection between the source and output attributes is lost. This is because I changed neighborhood name to neighborhood. I can fix this by simply dragging a new connection from the neighborhood name yellow output port to make the output neighborhood port change from red to green. This means that your attribute is connected. We call this schema mapping.